Headline inflation slowed to 7.6% in March after hitting a 14-year high to start 2023. 7.6%, however, remains quite high, and shoppers, especially those on a tight budget like pensioner Milagros Peralta Igacenza, say they haven't felt any relief.
Kailan kaya?
Hindi talaga.
Hindi kaya talaga. Kailangan talaga. Hindi lang iisa magana buhay. Hindi kami mga estudyante pa. Hindi kaya.
Data from the PSA show inflation in the first quarter averaged 8.3%, more than double the high end of the Philippine Central Bank's preferred range of 2 to 4%. Core inflation, which strips out volatile food and energy items, accelerated to 8% last month, its highest level since 1999. Analyst Jonas Ravela says the Philippine Central Bank may have to do more to rein in inflation expectations and any demand-side pressures.
I don't think the BSP is finished with its rate hikes, although it could be a smaller rate hike, which what we've seen of 25 basis points. So probably we could see another maybe two more hikes, probably closer to 7%. And hopefully we don't get affected by the rise in oil prices.
National statistician Undersecretary Dennis Mapa says inflation remains elevated, especially for the poor, with the bottom 30% income households suffering through an inflation rate of 8.8% in March, 1.2 percentage points higher than the national average. He adds, the oil situation Ravelas alluded to, sparked by surprise production cuts by the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, could also push inflation higher.
Kung titingnan natin yung nangyari in the last year, nung February, March, and so on. So, una muna, of course, ang effect niya doon sa price ng gasoline diesel, which is what we are monitoring, medyo mabilis yun. Pero yung isa natin nakita, and I think I mentioned this in the previous press conference, yung effect niya doon sa transport, yung effect niya doon sa presyo ng ibang commodity groups that are being delivered through, let's say, land and so on. Medyo may lag yun, and ang nakita namin about 2 months.
Aside from oil, the PSA is also monitoring agricultural output and any negative effects the dry season and the El Nino phenomenon might have on local food supply. Rice supply is of particular interest. Rice inflation remains low, but it has been creeping up steadily this year, a big problem for poorer households who tend to consume more rice and less of everything else just to get by. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.